Assalamualaikum, hello, hi, and welcome to Cooking is Fun with Firdaus. And as we all know, Eid is coming up, and we all are planning on making some special biryani. So here you go. I'm once again sharing a very traditional Hyderabad biryani with a slight touch of my biryani to it. It's going to be very simple and very easy to make. Especially during this lockdown, you can enjoy a restaurant-style biryani at home with no compromise to it. So let's get started. I'm taking a pot in which I'm going to cook my biryani. To the same pot, I have added the chicken, which is already cleaned. And now to this I'm adding ginger garlic paste along with yogurt and biryani masala, red chili powder, turmeric powder, coriander powder and salt. Ingredients in the description box clearly mentioned, guys, you can have a look at it. Once I add this, I'll be adding onion which are fried earlier. So you have to add fried onions, not the raw ones. Never do that. Then that will not be a traditional way. Along with tomatoes, green chilies, mint leaves, coriander leaves and lemon. And also some ghee and oil, because this will help your chicken to cook very soft and it'll be very tenderized and it'll be very juicy. So I'm just going to marinate all this together well, and in the same pot I'm going to cook the biryani. So I'm just settling the chicken well so that I just need to pour in my rice once it is cooked. So this will marinate for 30 minutes. Moving on, I have taken less than a half cup of milk, which is very hot right now. To this, I'm going to add less than a half teaspoon of saffron to it and mix this and set it aside. Let me just show you, I'm going to use these two colors, red and orange, for my biryani to give a beautiful, face for my biryani. And here to the rice while cooking, I'm adding garam masala along with Shahi Zira. Once it is 70% cooked, I'll drain it, and to the same pot I'll just add 1/3 of the rice first and evenly spread across. And to this I'll be adding in the saffron milk, orange food color I'll use now, and again spread across and the remaining rice, and add some ghee and red food color now along with fried onions, and sprinkle some coriander leaves and the mint leaves. Close the lid, and this needs to cook on a high flame for 10 minutes. And after 10 minutes you have to place a tawa below and put the pot on top of it, and then this needs to dum for about 20 to 25 minutes in a medium flame. So after 20 to 25 minutes, when you check, your rice will be beautifully cooked along with the chicken. There you go. Let me just show you how it looks. Lovely. Need to mix at this point of time very well and close the lid once again and leave it for dum for another 10 to 15 minutes for a better result. Once you do this, after 15 minutes you can check on. You can see the grains are a little longer and they look beautifully cooked, and the chicken is also much more tender now, and this is the right time your biryani is ready to be served. So there you go. I'm going to serve my biryani. So what's special at your home during your Eid, do share in. And also, if you're going to try this recipe, please let me know how was it. So stay tuned with Cooking is Fun with Firdaus. There's still lots more to come up. Inshallah, see you soon with another recipe. Until then, you take care. Allah Hafiz, and wish you Eid Mubarak. And I wish every one of you a very, very happy 2020 New Year. Guys, I know this is a very special occasion celebrating New Year, so I thought let's celebrate with some biryani recipe. Since my camel meat roast has got a wonderful response from you all, I'm so glad that I wanted to share my biryani recipe as well. So this is very simple, easy, delicious, and the best recipe for this occasion, guys. And for this recipe, I'll be using in camel meat with bone. And bone camel meat contains a little extra salt in it, so please try avoid using too much of salt in the biryani. To this we'll be adding ginger garlic paste along with the biryani masala, and ingredients in the description box below, guys, so please have a look at it. Red chili powder, turmeric powder, coriander powder. So as I told you earlier, I'm not going to add any salt at this point of time because my biryani masala already has enough salt in it, so I don't want to add more salt to it. And 1 tablespoon of vinegar, because my mama was saying that vinegar helps meat tender, not only right, but also it helps to give a best moisturized texture to your meat. So I will mix all these ingredients together with the gloves, guys. Wear on the gloves and then mix it. After 5 to 10 minutes of marination, we will add this to a pressure cooker. You can also use a pot, but I believe that pressure cookers are best to tenderize such tough meats, So we'll add 1 to 2 glasses of water, and this will take about 30 minutes in a medium flame or 15 to 20 whistles for sure. Once this is done, set this aside. Here I have 1/2 kg of India Gate Basmati rice. I'm going to soak this for 15 to 20 minutes. Next, we'll need fried onions, 2 large chopped tomatoes, chopped mint leaves 1 cup, chopped coriander 1.5 cup, few green chilies and 1 roughly chopped onion along with 1 lemon. Now we will be using fried onions, and this is fried earlier by me, and they are crispy golden brown. So bay leaf, cinnamon, cardamom, black peppercorn, hibiscus, nutmeg, clove and black cardamom is a must for your garam masala. Okay, let me check on the meat. It's tendered. It looks the best. Okay, moving on next onto a nice clean pot. I'm going to add 3 tablespoons of oil along with the garam masalas. If you want, you can add ghee also, but I avoid that right now. Ginger garlic paste, 2 tablespoons. Chopped coriander, mint, green chilies and tomatoes. Just mix all this together and add biryani masala, 2 to 3 teaspoons. And red chili powder, 1 teaspoon. Mix this. Again, I'm not adding salt because biryani masala has enough salt, so I feel we need not add more salt. Squeeze the lemon, mix it well, and here we are adding roughly chopped onion. You know why we are adding this? Because this is Ambur biryani special. I have seen somewhere people adding roughly chopped onion to it, so I felt let me try that for this recipe. So we'll just add roughly chopped onion and also fried onion, few fried onions, and mix it well, and add some yogurt around 1 cup. Give a mix, close the lid and let this cook for about 5 to 10 minutes in a medium flame because we want all the masalas to ooze out. Meanwhile, we will cook the rice also. We'll start cooking in the rice. Okay, here I'm adding, after 5 to 10 minutes, I'm adding in the cooked meat, the camel meat to it. And this is called akhni. Yeah, in Urdu we call this akhni. So once that's mixed, again, cook it for 5 to 10 minutes and check. Beautiful aroma. Now my rice is cooked, 70%. I'm just adding all the rice. Gently tap it over, and before mixing it, I'll just add on the saffron water on top of the rice and mix the rice first on top, and then sprinkle a little bit of red food color because biryani looks nothing without the red food color. It's like, you know, a bride without the jewels or makeup. Okay, now I'm going to mix it all. I know. Okay, I'm going to mix all this and then drizzle the ghee, 2 teaspoons of ghee, and some fried onions with some chopped green leaves, and then let this steam for 15 to 20 minutes on a tawa, okay, for sure. And then after 15 to 20 minutes, it's ready, and I'm gonna serve this along with some raita. I will be sharing in the raita recipe also. Do have a look at it. And you all just watch and enjoy, and I'm going to eat and enjoy. Okay guys, so this is what my biryani is ready for the New Year celebration. So share what is your New Year celebration, and also what is your New Year resolution. Many of us do take a resolution that we are going to have a healthy lifestyle for the year, but how many of us do really follow that? I don't know what I should say, but anyways guys, I really had fun time. Thank you for the entire year, the love and the support that you guys have shown me. I'm so happy. With the due respect, I am very very happy to have you all as my viewers. So thank you once again, and wish you all a very happy new year. Take care. Allah Hafiz. Bye. Okay guys, here you go. Let's start with the recipe now. Let's see how to make this steaming hot biryani for the Eid special. Here I'm taking around 1 kg of chicken to marinate, and to this we will be adding about 3 tablespoons of ginger garlic paste, lemon juice, biryani masala around 3 tablespoons, red chili powder, turmeric powder and salt as per taste. Now we'll marinate all these ingredients together. Mix this well and marinate for minimum 30 minutes. While the chicken is getting marinated, let's make our fried onions first. So we are going to add around 1.5 cup of oil along with some garam masalas and add the sliced onions. Ingredients list in the description box, guys. So we will add the onion and fry this onion until they are nice brown and crispy. You know, they turn nice brown and crispy. So once this is done, we will just remove them in a kitchen towel and keep it aside. And in the same oil, we are going to add the marinated chicken pieces, so that we need to fry the chicken pieces on both the sides evenly. So let's add the chicken pieces and fry them on both the sides. Don't add more oil to this, because this oil is going to be there throughout the biryani rice. So add the chicken pieces, close the lid and let this cook on both the sides. You have to cook. Let me just show you how it is done. After around 15 to 20 minutes, I'm going to check on my chicken pieces. I have cooked on both the sides. So you can see, let me show you a piece. Maybe that will be more helpful. There you go. They are slightly, you know, brownish in color. Now to this, I will add about 1.5 cup of yogurt and just mix quickly so that my yogurt doesn't curdle too much and it gives a smooth texture to it. Now, once this is cooked, what we'll do is we'll just set this aside. So let's prepare the steamed rice. To prepare the steamed rice, take a nice clean pot. You need to cook about 1.5 kg of total rice. So we'll add a half cup of oil to it and we'll add the whole garam masalas along with the sliced onions. Saute them and then add ginger garlic paste, and then once you saute it well, add tomatoes and chopped coriander leaves, green chilies and mint. Once you saute it well again for 2 to 3 minutes, you'll add the biryani masala, which is about 1 tablespoon, along with the salt. Now mix this all the ingredients together well and cook for about 2 to 3 minutes in a medium to low flame. And moving on, once this cooks, you just need to add. So the water measurement for this is going to be 1:1. So if you're going to use 1 cup of rice, so you need to calculate 1 cup of water for it. So that's how we are going to add the water. Just ensure it boils well and then you drain the rice well. The rice is soaked for about 30 minutes. You drain the rice well and you add to the boiling liquid. Now this needs to cook on a very, very medium to low flame for about 15 to 20 minutes until your rice is halfly done. So halfly done means it will still look raw. You can see very well, I'm showing the water is still left over and my rice is still raw. Now this is the right time I'm going to leave this rice for dum, which means for steam, in a very low flame for another 5 to 10 minutes. So the entire water will evaporate. So after 5 to 10 minutes, the water has completely evaporated. Rice is beautifully steamed. It is not messy or smashy. You can see the grains are individually cooked and it's beautiful. Moving on, once this is done, I will take the chicken pot back. And to this same chicken pot, I'm going to just add the entire steamed rice to it and level it up. And then add some saffron milk here. I have some saffron milk with me. And some ghee, and once I do that, I'll just drizzle some food color, add orange, red, yellow, and then chopped fried onions along with some fried whole garam masalas, which you will have along with the onions. There you go. Now this needs to steam for about 25 to 30 minutes in a very medium flame, medium to low flame, on a tawa. So steam this well, and after 25 to 30 minutes, when you open it up and when you start mixing in your rice, you will see a beautifully colored steamed biryani rice is ready for you guys, which is 100% perfectly achieved with the perfect flavors. And the best recipe that you can try for this Eid is here right now. So please go ahead, try this recipe and also share among your family and friends. Maybe it can help someone to make the best biryani today on this special occasion. So thank you guys, thanks for watching. Please stay tuned with Cooking is Fun with Firdaus. There's still lots more to come. Until then, you take care. Allah Hafiz. Stay safe, be at home, and please have a wonderful celebration at home. Wishing you all a very, very hearty, happy Eid. Thank you guys. Allah Hafiz. Today we are going to see how to make mutton chops biryani, and the twist is we are going to give a butter flavor to it. So we need 750 grams of mutton chops, and I'm gonna make this biryani masala in the pressure cooker. So onto our cooker, I'm adding salted butter along with the oil and few biryani garam masalas. I have clearly mentioned in the description box below all the ingredients for this biryani masala. I'll be adding 3 large onions which are sliced and fry them until they are nice, golden, crispy and brown in color. Once that's done, I'm going to add about 2 to 3 tablespoons of ginger garlic paste and give it a nice mix, and then I'm going to add about my chops. Give a nice mix to this, and then moving on further, we'll add yogurt. About 1 cup of yogurt, and mix them well together. And then I'm going to add 2 to 3 tomatoes chopped, medium sized tomatoes chopped, along with coriander leaves, mint leaves and green chilies. Mix all this together. Moving on with biryani masala. Here my biryani masala is homemade and I have lemon powder added to it. So I'm not adding lemon extract right now. So if you are using any store-bought masala, 1 whole lemon extract is needed. Red chili powder, 1 to 2 teaspoon. Coriander powder, 1 teaspoon. Turmeric powder, 1 teaspoon, garam masala, 1/2 teaspoon, and salt, 1.5 teaspoon. Mix all this well together along with the chops and add about 1 or 1/2 cup of water. Gently give a tap to all your chops and then close the lid and cook for about 30 to 40 minutes in a medium flame or until 10 to 12 whistles. After 10 to 12 whistles, the pressure is released and I checked onto my chops, masala is ready. Now onto a non-stick pot, I'm going to add 10 grams of salted butter and just place the chops in the bottom. So the bottom of the pot is covered with the chops and I'm layering the rice. This is 70% cooked basmati rice, about 3 to 4 cups. And on top of that, the rest of the remaining gravy, the biryani masala gravy, I'm going to pour it on top of the rice and gently layer it well. And give it a tap to the rest of the rice along with some food color. Here I'm using saffron extract with 1/3 cup of milk and just 2 to 3 drops of saffron extract. This is something new in the market, so I just wanted to give it a try, but you can use a whole saffron if you have it. Moving on, I'm just going to pour a little bit of butter here and there and then close it, and with the help of an iron cast pan, I'm going to dump this for about 15 to 20 minutes, medium to high flame. After 20 minutes, I'm going to check on my biryani. It looks amazing. All right, it's ready now. But still, I want to just check completely that all the sides have been, you know, well, the biryani is well done on all the sides. So I'm going to just check on the meat as well, the chops, they look cooked. I'm going to dump this for another 10 to 15 minutes. And after 10 to 15 minutes, I'm going to serve my chops biryani. I hope you like this recipe. Do try this and share your comments below. Very simple, easy and quick to make. Okay, there you go. I served it along with some nice chicken fry and boiled eggs and some nice onion raita. Hope you enjoy this recipe. Stay tuned with Cooking is Fun with Firdaus. There's still lots more to come. Until then, Allah Hafiz.
So let's begin with the marination now. We'll add ginger garlic paste, curd, that's salt, tandoori masala, 1 teaspoon of red chili powder, less than 1 teaspoon of coriander. This biryani masala recipe is already there in the videos, so you can have a look. So biryani masala, I'm going to add around 3 to 4 tablespoons of biryani masala. Now since my biryani masala already has enough of garam masala, I will not add too much. So here we go with only 2 cloves, 2 star anise pods, 1 nutmeg, just 2-3 mace flakes, small pieces of cinnamon, 2 cardamom cloves. Now let's pour in the oil. Now we are not going to add ghee at this point of time. We'll save this. Later we are going to add this. So let's mix all the masalas together. Okay. So now let this marinate. So once this marination is done, we'll add this ghee to the chicken. I have a baking tray with me wherein I can easily put around 1.5 kg of chicken and then layer the rice on top of it. So I'm just going to brush it with some ghee which is left in my hand. Apply the ghee to the chicken pieces. Now we will place the chicken pieces onto this baking tray. There you go. Use gloves, guys. Very important. Safety first. Okay. So this is done. Now I'd like to show you how you have to bake this. The oven is getting preheated at 250 degrees Celsius. Here you go. Now this is gonna cook, bake in the oven for 35 to 40 minutes.
While the chicken is getting baked, we will get the other things ready, like fried onions. Here I have used 2 large onions sliced and fried, 1/2 cup of mint, 1 cup of chopped coriander, 3 to 4 green chilies, you can increase the numbers you want, 1/2 lemon, and 1 large tomato chopped finely.
So just have a look at the chicken, how beautifully it's getting baked.
Now the chicken is coming off the oven. We have our vegetables, onion, fried, and everything is ready here. So now we'll start with the layering. So let's begin layering. First, I'll drizzle some mint leaves along with some coriander leaves and chopped tomatoes, fried onions, some green chilies, and squeeze the lemon. So after squeezing in the lemon, I'm going to layer my rice. This is 60% cooked rice. So once I layer this, give a nice tap. Nice thick layer, okay? And then drizzle again coriander leaves, mint leaves, fried onions, chopped tomatoes, and few green chilies. There you go. So once this is done, we will layer another layer of rice now. But this is going to be a thin layer, not a thick layer. As I told you, it is 60% cooked rice. So once I layer this, I'm going to drizzle some saffron water which I have soaked already with some saffron strands and some red food color because it adds a good texture to your biryani. Once this is done, I'm going to wrap it using a aluminium foil. And this is going to bake in the preheated oven at 250 degrees Celsius for 40 minutes. Minimum 40, so maximum 60. So once this is done, let me open it up. I can smell beautiful aroma all over my kitchen and this looks so yum, guys. Very less oil, very less ghee, yet we get to enjoy your healthy recipe. So you should definitely give it a try and you should share your experience in the comments below. Let me know how was it. Look at the layer of rice grain. It's like just like restaurant style, but better than the restaurant ones. Steaming hot biryani is ready, and I'm going to take my bite. Let me show you. The chicken is so beautifully cooked and tendered. Normally chickens are never cooked tendered. They get little tougher, and if they get tougher, they don't taste good. But this one, I'm sure, I'm going to taste and tell you. This is so good.
Okay guys, here you go. The biryani is ready now. The baked biryani is ready. So do try this recipe and share your comments below. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned. There's still lots more to come with Cooking is Fun with Firdaus.